Hi friends, this is Fani Bhushan Nagla. Today we are going to learn data-driven framework using Excel. So in our earlier session, we have seen data-driven using data provider annotation, and also we have used parameters in testing the .xml suite, and we also used .properties file. So now today we will be passing the test data from Excel. So Apache is providing very, very good library like Apache Py. So this library is capable to read and write both XLS and also XLSX formats. So now today we will be, let's prepare the test data in Excel format. So I'll just use one email ID and the password. Yeah, as usual, abcd@gmail.com and the password 1234. So we have seen that the index of the first row and first column. So this is 0 and 0, and the zero row and first column for the password. Now let's go and download. Means because we are using Maven, we need to provide the dependencies to download the required Apache Py libraries. Let's go to the Maven repository and say mvnrepository.com and search for Apache Py. So we have to download both Apache Py and also Py XML. So Py and Py OO XML, both we need to download. Let's download the, let's copy this. Yeah, because 4.0 is recently released, so, and 3.17 is the earlier version, and there are more downloads. Yeah, so let's copy this 3.17. So these dependencies needs to be copied into our form.xml. So again, this is a dependency. Let's copy this into under the dependencies tag itself. Yeah, see here, I have copied these two here, both py and also py.oo.xml. So both I have copied here. Now let's go and write some program here. Now, as part of the launch program, now let's again let me create one more testng class. Testng class. I'll give the class name as DDF using Excel class and click on finish. What I will do is I'll copy this. Let me copy this event driver.quit also. And let's change the name of the method, login Facebook. Yeah, I think my test method annotation. Yeah, I think we need to create WebDriver. Let me use, because we're using only one, so WebDriver, download WebDriver, import WebDriver from Selenium. Now, so what should we do now? So we have created a Excel file, and let's save this one. Save as. Like to see this, save as type is XLSX. Now let me copy this to this place, and I'll say login_facebook. So this is in XLSX format. So when we use XLSX format, so what are the classes we need to refer to this to read the data from Excel file? So before that, what we should do is we need to use file class. Why do we need to use file class? So we need to provide the path of this file. So path, let's copy it, let's go to the, and here I am copying the login Facebook. So let's copy this path. Login Facebook, copy the path and provide this path here within this file. File is a class part of Java. So Java input output, import the packages related to file. So this we have seen as even earlier also. Now let's file. Now file, we need to use file input stream. File input stream to get the file in file input stream. So now we have passed, we have taken in the earlier command, we have taken the file path. Now we are passing this file path to the input stream. This input will be taken as file. Now I am using the source of this file path. Now even file input stream is also a class of Java. Now we have used, this is completely a Java code. So this whole file and Excel handling is completely part of Java code. Now file input stream is throwing some exception. So we need to use exception handling. Let's use the basic exception. Now we need to, we have used the, we have copied the path and now we the Excel file also given as an input. Now this Excel file needs to be referred. So we have a class called XSS workbook. It is a class which is a class in Apache Poi, so which helps us to implement the workbook related methods. Now let's go and provide this file input stream, which is our file. Now what is this XSF workbook? It is a Apache Poi class. This XSF will be asking for the suppress warnings. Let's go use it also. Now constructs a XSF workbook object by buffering the whole stream into memory and then opening an OPC package object for it. So I'm using an input stream requests more memory than using file. So if a file is available, then you should instead do something like, what is the suggestion? It is asking us to follow this method, but let's use the same format. We will use a only XSF workbook and the object name. So we will use XSF workbook class and create an object for this. I'll say workbook. Now we are able to access the workbook in the Excel sheet using this XSF workbook. Now we need to access the, so when you have Excel sheet is accessed now. Now we need to go and access the sheets which are there in the Excel workbook. Now there are different methods. So when you use this workbook object, you can able to access the methods dot we have get sheet. So get sheet, you can provide the string. So if you are using the name of the sheet, then you can provide the name. If you are using the index, then you can use sheet at, get sheet at. So if you want to access the first sheet, it is start, the index starts with the zero. If you are accessing the second sheet, it is a index one, index two, like that. So because now we are using index zero, let's provide the zero here. Now what it is doing here? No, it is returning XSF sheet. So this is the class, it represents the sheet. So now let's go and say XSF sheet. Create an object for this. Okay, I am using sheet. This is my object name. Let's import the packages also from Apache Py. Now sheet dot. Now we are able to access the sheet. Now we need to access the the data which is there in the sheet. So I have user email ID in row 0, column 0. So what we should do is sheet dot get, we have a method called get row, and get row, it takes integer row number. So as part of this I'm saying 0. So it is take the value from 0 column, 0 row, and get cell number 0. So here also we have 0 row 0, column 0. Row 0 and column 0, and dot get string cell value. So we are saying the cell value which is string value, that's what we are going to take. See, it's returning string, it is returning get the value of the cell as a string. So now let's use string and a variable called email. I'll use this email. Now let me use one more string password. So let me just copy this whole. Now this time I want to capture row 0 and column 1 index. So value from this row 0 and column 1 index. Let me change this set get cell value cell to 1. This value I want to pass it in the facebook.com email text box and password text box. So let's go and find the attribute and value, the unique attribute and value which we can use it. So we have name and ID for email. So this is email only. So we can use it, and let's go and find password also. The password is having ID equal to pass. Pass is the value of the ID attribute, and also we can use login. Login is having value attribute, so it is unique. So if you want to find whether it is unique or not, control F, and let's use XPath. Like I will just write XPath for this. I'll say at the rate value with the attribute, and within parentheses. Sorry, single quotes, say login. So this is one of one. So it is a unique value. Let's go to Eclipse now. Let me say driver dot find element dot py dot ID. So ID which I will take it for email. So this is email text box, and say send keys. So let me pass this email variable name as part of email text box. And again, let's take driver dot find element dot by dot ID. And here I'll take for this password text field. Let's take the ID equal to pass. So pass and dot send keys provide the string variable password. Yeah, now I want to click on driver dot find element by dot xpath. So within this xpath, let's pass this value. So it is xpath. I want to click on this login button. So before clicking, so let me use this thread dot sleep. And I just want to show you this data, whether it is entered or not. Maybe I'll let me use this dot sleep after entering the password. And let's go and close the workbook. So otherwise, what happens is the objects will occupy memory. Workbook dot close. So let's, I'm done with my, so we, because we have it in the, now this time let's go and create, convert this into test engine. So I want to use the same test engine.xml. Let's, I'm not going to create one more one. So let's overwrite it. Yeah, it's overwritten. Let me go to pom.xml and right click, run as Maven test. Now let's see how this execution will happen now. So it is, so encoding to copy filter resources, recompiling the module. The compiling is going on, test compile, test resources, and default test. Now the test, compiling two resource files. So under, we have two files, two Java files under, so it is compile all the two, but we are going to execute only one part of the testing.xml file. So it launched the Chrome browser. Now test, yeah, it is opening facebook.com also. Yeah, it's going to pass email and password. So yeah, it entered. So it's waiting for, we used thread.sleep, so it is waiting for 5 seconds before it, yeah, now it's clicking on the login also. You can see, yeah, it's clicked on this and it's closed workbook, and also it closed the, we use driver.quick, so the browser window session closed now. So if you see this, the result, test run, and no failures, no errors, no skips. So its build is successful and test execution is successful. So this is the way we need to read the data from Excel. So in our next lesson, we will try to understand, practice little complex Excel reading and writing. Thanks for watching the session.